For this year, I had planned not to take on any client projects, but instead to fully focus on my Webflow courses, on this YouTube channel here, on tutorials, and of course on my new web design school called Formburg, and not to get distracted by any other projects. So far, that has actually worked out really well. I only helped out one friend here from the neighborhood with a project which was very experimental and something I was genuinely excited about. And still, I noticed that income-wise and in terms of revenue, I was not quite on the same level as I was used to from a client work in the past years. So I thought, what could I possibly launch this year to round things off a little bit more successfully in a way that gives me the honest feeling I can keep pushing this forward in the future. And maybe it is also in your interest that you keep finding free videos here and learning material on this channel. So I created a survey on my social media accounts, what kind of course could I still release? And the result was that many of you would love to see a new Webflow GSAP interactions course from me, especially now that the GSAP animations can be visually animated with a timeline natively inside of Webflow. That feature only came out this year, so it is probably still very new for many of you. And even when I talk with some of you here and there, it turns out that many of you have not yet started to go all in into the new GSAP interactions. But I promise you, they are so much more powerful than the old Webflow interactions. In the past months, I have already worked with it pretty heavily, especially in my Nova Mars project, which I submitted for the Webflow challenge. And it even made it into the top builds and was showcased at this year's Webflow conference. So it was kind of an initial project where I wanted to learn a lot about these new interactions. And I also played around with GSAP a lot in my free time. And here on this YouTube channel, you find many free tutorials about it. And I'm now at a level where I could actually create a solid compact course for GSAP. And I made it my goal to finish that within this year. And why a compact course? Because I simply thought not everyone always wants to work through, 80 new course videos. I would also appreciate something that is just maybe around 20 with videos where you learn something specific that is newly added to the Webflow Designer. So this week, I created a layout that I'm calling the Atelier. And I just looked at what kind of Webflow templates sell the most. And usually portfolios and agency sites, those studio type pages that are just very popular within the Webflow template ecosystem. And then I thought, why not go for it? Generate a few awesome images with AI, gather some ideas, and then build a layout, something that must be attractive and appealing. Otherwise, you would not want to rebuild it or go through it with me together in the course. And that is why I said the Atelier is basically a fictional studio and we will use that as our guide. You will, of course, get the entire project with all animations for free afterwards, just like always with my courses. All the material is included. And I thought we would start from the ground up, go through all the basics very slowly. And by the end, we want you to come out of this course as a pro. And that is why we will include some simple stuff, but also elements that still look great, but are easily to implement and create. And I can tell you, these new GSAP animations are super, super easy to use for things that previously with the old Webflow interactions would have required you to build endlessly long lists just to get a single interaction done. And now you can run through it all with just a few settings, and there are so many cool tricks you can apply. I think this layout will be a fantastic example for it. We will include a few elements like hover effects. For instance, maybe some icons appear here on hover or perhaps on an accordion effect. But this one here will definitely have a very, very cool page load animation. I have already tested some animations out for this one with various cards sliding in and revealing this hero section. We will also have some fake project teasers, and in this case for a dream serum. Since I have not been sleeping that well lately, I thought this is exactly what I want and what I need, so I made a case out of it. And here you can see a special teaser that you normally might not include because it would be too complex, but in a course like this it makes total sense to create something special where we can nicely practice letter effects, automations, looping animations, stagger animations, and so on. And then also some more regular teasers where we might integrate cool hover effects. Of course, we also want to normal text, titles, etc. to be animated, exploring what animations options are there for using attributes, for example. And things like beautiful parallax effects, scroll animations, we also include in this area here with a marquee scroll-based transition. So all the stuff you are used to seeing in modern websites. We also look at, for example, navigation menus that you can open and close, simple click animations, maybe animate different grid view lists, meaning a nice grid that animates into a list layout. And all of that can be now done natively with the new GSAP animations in a custom-made way. I have made a rough list of what we could include, starting with an intro on what makes working with animations feel truly professional. And this is still a rough outline here for now because I want to start recording the English videos next week. I have already recorded some German ones, and of course some things will be added along the way, but maybe it gives you an idea. And if there is something specific you would like me to cover, feel free to leave a comment below this video. And if you are interested in joining, just click the link in the description. We will work through everything step by step, including advanced animations, scroll effects, mask scroll animations, and so on. Even up to custom JS events, which is a new functionality and super interesting if you work a little bit more advanced in projects with custom code, meaning animations that you create visually in Webflow without writing code can still be triggered later in your project via custom code, which can be super powerful. So you can see this course will be a bit more compact, and I really do not plan to launch it at a high price. So for anyone who wants to make a small year-end investment, something that might help you offer new things to your clients in the coming year, I think this would be a great fit. So once the course goes live, the price you see now on the landing page will no longer be available. It will only go up from there, and I'm not a fan of discounts or Black Friday deals. That is not how I work. So if you join early, you get the best price, and after that it will increase. So take a look and consider whether you want to jump in. I'm genuinely excited to build this compact course, and maybe I will see you there. And of course, there will also be a proper trailer later on, not just a preview video like this one.